If you study with Quizlet or you study with Google Translate, I'm going to show you a great trick today. Did you realize that you can take your words from Google Translate, click on one button, and then bring them into Quizlet and turn them into cards in just a few seconds? This can save you so much time, and it means there's a brilliant link between Google Translate and Quizlet. I'm going to quickly show you how to do this. It's going to save you time. It's a great way of studying, and I'm going to show you a couple of tips about exactly what I do. Really hope you like the video, and as always, if you do, please share it, please like it, please comment on it. Love to know what you think of this idea, and of course, join me on my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So let me start by showing you the trick, and then I'll show you exactly how I do it. I've got here some words that I've been saving in my Google Translate, and to save a word, you simply put it in and then click on Save, but we'll come back to that. I've got 25 phrases here. I'm going to click on this button here and export all of those words into a Google Sheet. And to do that, I just click on that button there and then this button here to import the words. Now, all I need to do is copy the words that I want to bring in to Quizlet. And let's just grab a few. I can obviously take the lot. All I need to do is I'm using my shift key to select the words I want to save. Let's say these ones here. Okay, very, very simple to do that. All I'm doing is using shift and the arrow key to select the words I want to copy, and then I'm going to press on copy, as that is it. All I need to do now is paste those words into Quizlet. Let me show you how I do that. So I've got Quizlet open here on the screen. I'm going to click on Create Study Set. Now, this is where you're really going to save yourself a lot of time. If I just write in the words, and let's say, for example, New Words, okay, is my title, then I click on this button here, and all I need to do now is actually paste in by just pressing Control V, or of course I can right click and press paste, and there are the words I've got from my Google Translate, and I click on import, and now I've got all of those words ready. And if I click on create, we can start to actually work with these words. Now, I'm going to show you a couple of tips when working with Quizlet, and then I'll quickly go back and show you how to use Google Translate. When I work with Quizlet, I tend to work with phrases, not individual words. I much prefer to work with phrases. Remember that if you click on Options, what you can do is turn on the audio, click on Advanced, and then what I normally do is I have the English off because I speak English, but I have the Polish on. And this means now that when I
To
study,
jest potoczna fraza.
I've got the phrase in Polish, then I can try to translate it so that this is a colloquial phrase. Okay, then go to the next one.
Książka zawiera kasetę.
Okay, this the book includes a cassette.
Wiele angielskich słów jest zawartych w języku polskim.
Okay, so many English words are included in Polish language. Okay, so you can practice this way. So that's a great little tip just by using that button there and setting the options of the audio. You really can make it much more interesting. Another lovely thing to do is to use the play button, and this will just play the song words for
Spóźniłem
you.
się na taksówkę.
I'll just turn it off a minute. And one of the reasons what I do with this often is that I walk away from the computer and just listen to the words without reading them and seeing if I can remember the translations into English. So that's what I do with Quizlet. It works really well. I'm just going to quickly show you how I use Google Translate. Google Translate is really useful. Let's say, for example, I was listening to this video in Polish and there was this sentence here that I wanted to understand in English. I can just copy that, jump over to my Google Translate, paste in the word in Polish, so you can choose the language that you want. You can just click here to choose any language that you want to work with. And I'm going to work from Polish to English. I just paste in the word. It gives me the translation. And then what I can do, if I want to add that to my collection of words to save, I just click there. And then that word will be added. Notice you can even open up your list of saved words by clicking here at the bottom. So each word that you save will come in this list here, and you can even listen to them.
Na przykład planować. krem po goleniu.
Okay, and then remember what I showed you, just click on that button there, and that brings those words into a document, which you can then copy and then bring into Quizlet. And that's the trick that I use. One little thing, when you do this, make sure that you kind of pull the word, the spaces out, just to make sure that you've got the complete word. Okay, always do that, especially when you're, it's easy when you're working with single words, but if you're working with sentences, it's important to just make that sure that you create the space for the words to completely go in one box. That's a really important trick before you copy them. So just bring them out nice and wide like that. And then what I do is I simply click on Shift and the arrow key, and then click down on the arrow key to select all the words that I want to copy. Once I've selected them, just right click and click on copy. And now you're ready to go. Paste them in, one click and you're off. Really hope you found that video useful. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Plenty more free videos on all sorts of things. If you want to follow my courses, you'll also see those at the top of the screen. And if you scroll down, you'll see lots of free videos. Most of the stuff is focused on language teaching, so it's really technologies for language teaching. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you will get updated with all the latest videos, the blogs, the webinars, and the courses I run. And at the moment, if you sign up, you'll also get a 12-part free course, which is sent to you every 5 days, a video about using technology in teaching and learning. Of course, you can sign up to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell to get the updates. And finally, if you do want to contact me, then you can contact me from my website, teachertrainingvideos.com. And obviously, I do lots of training in using technologies with teachers, conferences, presentations, etc. I'm going to leave a couple more videos now on the screen about Quizlet that you might find useful.